So good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Thanks for taking time out. It's a pleasure to welcome Anand sir. So as I was just saying, Anand hi Anand hai. And on top of it, the topic itself is something which is relevant to each one of us. The topic today is campus to corporate. All of us have gone through the life on campus, and we definitely remember, we definitely cherish that every moment that we spent on the campus. I'm sure there's nobody who can say that that period we don't want to live all over again. And then the other piece is corporate. This is that space where we have our dreams. The challenge is so. Campus challenge, sorry, campus challenge, corporate, these three things, these are the three C's of life. Okay. Today we are going to look at it from another perspective. And Anandji was just sharing that he read a book, and on top of it, the experience that he's gained over the years, he's going to share that with us. So today it's all about campus to corporate. What are the different aspects? How do we go beyond it? And how we as entrepreneurs can support to bridge this gap and change it from a challenge to an opportunity. So, Anand sir, all yours.
Thank you very much. Good evening, Atul ji, and good evening, everybody. The topic name is Campus to Corporate. Now, campus, you will be definitely understanding that we are studying our engineering, our MBA, and other activities also. In addition to that, corporate, where we really work for years together. And when we started our life in corporate, we also struggled. I am sure everybody must have struggled by some or the other means. Maybe culture, maybe communication, maybe presenting yourself, maybe you are not able to compete, something like that. So there are multiple things which makes man fail at the corporate life. So I thought that I was just going through one book of Mr. Deshpande, that is Campus to Corporate, which is he's a professor of Symbiosis. Now he's not a professor, but he wrote a book, and when I was going through that book, and when I found that it is very relevant in today's situation, in the existing campuses, colleges, and similarly, it is in the corporates also. Campus always says that our people doesn't get good opportunity in the corporate or in the industry, whereas corporate says they are not getting good candidates or they are not getting good managers. So then, where to stand, where to break this line or the gap, and how we'll be able to bridge it? I'm trying to cover few points because it's a very vast topic, very large topic, and just trying to bridge certain things which I understood and I found that they're relevant and it should be a part of the education system. I don't blame institutes also because they have to follow certain norms given by the university, by the existing education policy. But apart from that, what we'll be able to do for these students and your growth like platforms should definitely ensure that we do something differently than what we are doing even today. So it's an opportunity. One is we are looking after the business, there is no doubt about that. We are trying to give the consultancy in different fields, aspects of our business. We are going for ask, we are going gives, etc., etc. But what exactly is required to be building the nation for the future? Unless now Sucheta ji is there in the industry, other people are also there in the industry, whether they are really going to get the good people, whether their load will be shared by these new people, whether they're capable of doing so? No. The answer is no. Exceptionally, one or two people will be there, but they are also not complete in all respects. So I'll start with my presentation. It's visible. Is my presentation visible to everybody?
Yes, it is.
Okay, good.
Yes, it is visible.
Thank you. So, I thought that it's a lifelong learning because the day we start taking education and the day we join corporate, continuously we have to learn improving ourselves. We produce MBA certificate holders and not the managers. So, this is what is the say of the industry. This is what is the say of the corporates. And unless we really put something in apart from the regular syllabus, which needs to be taught to them as a rule, regulations, or the education policy, or as a binding of the university, we need to do something different apart or in addition to the existing syllabus which they are learning today. And unless we create that situation, that win-win situation between the campus and the corporate is not going to be there. Why? Our children are our future. The young generation today, those who are studying maybe in the engineering, maybe in the colleges, maybe in the MBA schools, they are the future of our country, even ours. Economic viability depends on how our future workforce is capability, personal effective enhancement, being effective in the organization, whether it's technologically skilled, excelling through placement process. Now, simple, I'll tell you, we have to build the future of our youngsters. Then how we do that? We know that our children are our future. They are going to be helpful for developing the GDP or economy of the country. Personal enhancement for the every individual is essential. Being effective in organization, whether he is effective in the organization, how to make him more effective than what he is there in the college today, whether he has acquired, see nowadays it's not one single one skill or two skill or something like that. Everybody has to have multiple skills now. And whether we are making them skilled to the requirement of the corporate, that is what is my question. Excelling through placement process, and we have to see that they succeed in their placements and they go through the process of win-win situation so that they don't fail in the future also. Sorry. So we'll go one by one. Now, what exactly we are talking about? It's a college and it's a corporate. It's a transition from being a student to becoming a professional student. Gain the confidence to perform a job, yet will be open to learn much of the job. Actually, I was talking to the MBA students during my last this 15 days conversation which I was having in the MBA college. I talked to the people and I asked student, why you did MBA? He said, good salary, white collar job. I said, okay, fantastic, nothing wrong in that. What kind of job you want? He wants manager's job. Then I asked, what kind of salary you expect? He said, 1 lakh rupee. I said, what experience you have? He said, there is no experience. Then why somebody should take you? That is first part of it. Secondly, even if you are selected, company will be spending or corporates will be spending few days, few months to train you on your whatever you have learned in the campus. And then you start finding that there is a lot of difference between what he has learned in the campus and what is expected by the industry. Now, if you just look into this comparison which I did, what is there in the mind of the student? Exams are the major qualifying criteria. आप रट करो, examinations में पास हो जाओ, you get a qualification, you become MBA. And then you said, I am an MBA student. Fantastic. Minimum marks to pass, आपको 60% चाहिए. So there is no question, if I get 60% of the marks, the criteria is over. So then he is not bothered for achieving 80%, 90% or 100%. Maximum efforts can fetch through 100% marks. hours per day is limited. If he spends 2 to 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours, he is definitely going to do studies and get through the exams. And it is up to him individually. Even if he passes or fails, it is not going to affect the other students. Memorize and remember. It's a style. Mr. Abhay Kulkarni is there from MGM College. He'll definitely understand and he will appreciate what I'm saying. Ki people, they go through the last 10 years, as examination paper. Then they find out the answers. And after that, they rut it. They write whatever they, and then they get 80% also. It doesn't matter. Practical what they learn out of what they are learning today, maybe in engineering or maybe in MBA students, it is hardly 25% of the practical which they get involved into. Other students' work will not mind you. What others are doing, I am not worried also. Mujhe mere ko pass hona hai. That's my aim. Kitna 60% minimum mark lena, I get MBA degree and then I pass it. Okay. Whereas what exactly is there in the corporate? Each day is important. Every day is important because every day your target is going to be achieved, needs to be achieved. Always need excellence, survival for the fittest. Those who are fit, those who are ready to perform only will remain in the organization. Maximum efforts you have to put, increment, elevation. Your productivity is very important. How much you are giving to the organization against what you are being paid. There is a simple formula. Corporate always says that, ki aapko main 100 rupees deta hun, to I want 200 rupees work from you. And unless you have that capability of giving 200 rupees back to the organization, organization is not going to pay you 100 rupees. Highly interlinked. Understand, remember and utilize. 100%. Now here we have seen practically it is hardly 25% in the college campuses. Whereas in the industry, you have to be 100% practical. You have to see that you perform. You do whatever you want to do. You have to see that you give the output of what is expected from you. Need versatility. You need different aspects of working. You must be good in communication, you must be good in writing, you must be good in skills, you must be in position to give solutions to the problems, and highly competitive within the unit. Wherever you are working, you have to be competitive. Unless you are competitive with your other competitors, unless you prove yourself to be useful to the organization, why an organization should pay you? Why they should retain you? In campus, we know that only learning takes place, creates the foundation for the future. A student enjoys more freedom. Exams are the major qualifying criteria. As I said, practically it is 25% only which you get involved into the practicals. Maybe they are taking you to some industry for the visits and just showing ki the aise industry chalti hai. But what exactly needs to be done to run that industry is not known to them. Whereas learning takes place in the industry while you are earning, builds the career and hence the future. An employee has to be more responsible. Evaluation is done on daily basis. Practically, you should be involved 100% in day-to-day activity of the industry where you work. Similarly, nowadays, ERP is not a subject in the college. It is just an introduction which has been given, but through that introduction, I found that nobody will understand anything. What exactly ERP, how it works? So if you are not having the ERP knowledge, you will be nowhere in the industry, you will be thrown out of the industry. So you have to see that the skills related to the ERP and other skills are also acquired by the individual. Corporate means relating to the large companies or to a particular large company. Okay. The elements of relationship, self-respect, mutual respect, compassion, cooperation, commitment, establishing the positive relationship, your communication style, your non-verbal communication, learning styles, boundaries, differing values, company culture, culture of the country, family culture. So first and the first most culture which you need to develop is in your family, within the family, how your culture is, then what you learn, wherever you have learned, or your college, what is the culture in your college, then what is the culture is going to be there in the company, because what you learn, you have to see that, you do that, perform that in the corporates also. And we must understand these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the requirements of the corporates. How we are going to learn this, we are definitely going to see that in the next slides. What is corporate? Corporate life cycle is the storage of growth, stages of growth and development that nearly every company goes through from the initiation of the company to its end. Startup stage, then it grows, establishment stage, and then the maturity stage. It is applying to both the students as well as to the industry. Because any company, when they are starting with the startup stage. The idea is developed, they start manufacturing some product, then they grow, then they establish, and then the maturity level comes. Similarly, students also should ensure that he goes through all these 1, 2, 3, 4 phases, which will help him to understand the practicality in the corporates. I am very happy I got MBA, I passed my MBA and then I got a job. I keep on communicating to my friends, families, etc., etc., etc. Job to mil jayega. But whether job, getting job is sufficient for you, whether you will be happy after some time, initially it is quite possible that you may find it interesting and all, but once you continuously start doing the similar job, then it is quite possible that you may go to the stagnancy. It is quite possible that you start disliking that particular daily routine activity which you will be doing in the industry. But those who are really interested in doing the career is most important. So compare job versus career, whether you are just a job oriented student or whether you would like to develop your career in the organization, at the corporate or wherever you go. I have shown specifically a picture of the Navy, whereas the student, that youngster wants to build his career in Navy. So something like that, whether students are being taught or being cultivated to create the liking about the career or making the career instead of the job. So that cultivation needs to be done at the campus level itself. What are the corporate expectations? These are the behavioral traits which I mentioned, which are expected. He should be optimistic. He should be self-motivated. We always say that be proactive instead of reactive. So he should be self-motivated, competitiveness, approachable, leadership skills should be there. He should have patience to learn, to stay back. Kya hota hai, all these young students nowadays, what I find that they reach at 9 o'clock wherever they get a job, and sharp at 5 o'clock, they will ensure that whether their job responsibility is completed or not, but they will leave the bus, they will leave the workplace. Or during the working hours also, it is quite possible that they may not be concentrating on what exactly they are supposed to learn, do it. In case if they have any difficulty, they will not go to the seniors or to the experts to find out what exactly needs to be done to see that he really builds his career. He develops all these traits which are expected from him in the organization. Then, so we understood that there are gaps, and then we must find out the ways in which this gap needs to be bridged. How we do that? do the SWOT analysis first of the campus college and simultaneously of the student also. So there should be a wing which will be taking care of finding out what is not there in the organization, what is not there in the campus, what is not there in the MBA school or engineering school, and similarly what is not there in, naturally if these are the practices which are not followed in the campus, it will not be penetrated into the students also. So we must do the SWOT analysis in the organization, we must do the SWOT analysis of the students also. Design the training content based on the SWOT, and then we must find out what are the gaps we have found out in the organization, in the campus or in the college, and based on that SWOT analysis, we must design the training needs. The gaps identification should be done, and we must think of these gaps, and then we should start working on bridging the gap. Include soft skills, aptitude and technical skills, conduct practical sessions, mock interview with a panel from real corporates. This is something we must bring in corporate people into the campus, arrange their lectures, organize their interviews so that students get used to these kind of practices, and will help them in building the confidence when they really want to go into the organization or at the corporate. Then again, after doing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, revisit the SWOT, whether there is any change in the organization has been brought in, whether the student has done some changes in his own activities which he is doing, and then design the success path. Unless you design, see, we have to make him successful. We have to see that he wins. So then whether the design of success path is made or not made needs to be ensured by the organization as well as the people, those who are conducting training of the students. Do a program mapping. See, we develop his etiquettes, rules and behavior. We develop digital etiquettes, then we develop professional conducts in the individual. We also teach him the communication styles. Seniors, if they are there, how to speak with them. Juniors, even if they are juniors, how to speak with them. Team building, dealing with the colleagues. Unless you become a team leader, or unless you have those qualities in you, you will not be able to take your people with you, your subordinates with you, or even if you will not be able to form the team. Time management, very important aspect of the industry, because everything is being counted on seconds, you know, tack time, or you know the cycle time, wherein everything is counted. Mujhe 3 second mein ek product bahar aana chahiye machine se, to aata hai ya nahi aata hai. Similarly, it is applicable to the individual also. So cultivate the habit of to-do list, and to-do list, I think everybody knows, I need not have to explain on that. I'm just skipping this. How will monitor the progress? Access skills gaps at the institution, choose training topics in the concurrence with the faculty, agree on training format, that is workshop, seminar, lectures. Finalize conducive training dates, customization of training curriculum material, deliver of training contents, ongoing engagements through online counseling. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 steps, if you start working on these, definitely some of this may be the part of your syllabus. But it is quite possible that all may not be the part of the syllabus. Then in that case, wherever we find gap, we must ensure that we incorporate those gaps as a part of the extra training which is required to be given to make him more successful, confident. Whether we have done the analysis, problem faced by the freshers, whether you have interviewed the freshers, when he joins the campus and when he leaves the campus and going to the corporate, whether somebody has talked to somebody or a group of students.
Sanitizer lata hai, do le aao na, upar ka bhi khatam.
Leak of, lack of guidance. So nobody is guiding them. So just aap MBA pass ho gaye, chale jao corporate mein. Placement wale ne bhi dekh liya college ke, out of that 10, 3 were good, so he introduced them and somehow the company wanted them, so they have been selected. So whether unko guide kiya hai properly? Lack of interpersonal skills, lack of real world experience, competition, whether you have made him aware about the competition which he is going to face in the corporate. So unless we give them the real picture, what he is expected to be there, how he is going to perform, that analysis unless we do, and unless we start taking care of him to see that he wins the situation at the corporate. What are the essentials? Education, definitely yes. He must be visionary. He must set his own goals, what he wants to be. Whether he is interested, whether he has developed some skills, whether he has developed some values. And once you go through the previous slides process, what we have discussed, I am sure education training will help him to develop his own visions, to practice him to make the goals of his life. He must develop the interest. He must develop the multiple skills, and automatically the values which he wants to inculcate within himself will be developed. Are you ready? That's what is my question. Then how, now the person has gone and he has entered into the corporate, and then we found that micro-sized contents can be targeted to specific jobs, problems and processes. Involve him in small, small activities in the organization, which gives him the direct exposure. And then before we put him, jaisa hum bolte hai, baudi mein tairna aana hai, to aap pehle usko baudi mein daalo, but before putting him into the well for the swimming training or in the swimming pool, we must give him some hints. Ye aisa hua to aisa karna hai, aisa hua to aisa karna hai. So that gives him a moral support to start learning swimming at the corporate level. Best in, give him videos, show him the success stories, then show how the things are happening in the industry or at the corporate. Strong interest factor presentation significantly improves and recall, not linear or overly programmatic in nature. Emphasis on simplicity minimizes friction. Very important. Ego. Main MBA ho gaya hun, so I must be given a good treatment in the company or in the office, or otherwise there is some ego clash with some senior who is already there at the corporate. So emphasis on the simplicity which minimizes the friction or distraction at the corporate level. Develop the habit of strategical thinking, managing risk, essentials of public relations, marketing in a digital age, recruiting, screening and onboarding effectively, effective business meetings, effective business writing, using email effectively in the workplace. Whatever you are communicating through email or verbally, you must ensure that it is to the specific, it is very to the point. Otherwise, you will be writing many things, but the actual meaning or the actual message which you would like to communicate may not be there in that content. Improving your work or life balance. Diversity on the job. Try to learn. I have joined as a commercial manager, but it doesn't mean that you should not know anything about the manufacturing, or you should not know anything about the finance, or you should not know anything about the planning. So try to learn wherever it is possible for you, which will enhance, which will improve your understanding capabilities in the organization. Discovering your strengths. And when you start learning the things, and if you learn fast, automatically what happens, you learn what strengths you have in you. I always ask during my trainings also, I always ask students, or even in the organizations also, I always ask people to write their weaknesses and strengths. It is very difficult to write your strengths, as well as it is very difficult to accept your weaknesses or your negative points. But I force them to write, and 1 or 2, 5, 20, whatever they write, I ask them, forget about the positive things which you have mentioned in your life or in your paper, but negativity, whatever negative points which you have, okay, I'm not able to, I'm afraid of speaking in English, for example. So what you have done to improve upon that negative point, whether you are doing something, because unless you develop the activity or you start doing something on taking, going away from your negative points, it is not going to be converted as a positive point. It is quite possible, it may not happen overnight, it may take 6 months, it may take even 1 year. But unless you start working in that direction, it is not going to happen. So develop your strengths, discover your strengths, and start working on your negative points. Automatically, one by one, all your positive points will start increasing and your negative points will go down. We must be in a position to teach these kind of things at the campus level itself. We say always in the industry, first time right. So first time, if we cultivate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 types of habits in an individual, in the students at the campus stages itself, I'm sure he'll be able to go as a good manager in the first stage itself. He'll be able to manage the performance. Managing in difficult times, because it is quite possible that many times we face some difficult situation in the organizations, some sudden problem crops up, and if we are not trained to meet these kind of difficulties, we'll fail. Developing leadership skills, very important. Unless you are able to take everybody with you, you'll not be able to prove yourself to be a good leader. Woman in leadership, managing your career. While doing all these things, you should ensure that you should not forget your goal. You should not forget what exactly you would like to be in your career in future. Interview skills. We must teach them what exactly, as I said in the previous slide also, that we must organize some corporate people to come to the campus, organize the interviews with the students. They automatically understand what corporate is expecting from the student. And then they will get used to those kind of questions, panels. 10 people are asking 10 questions to me. So prepare them from that point of view, so that importance you give for the interview. See, it's very specific. 40% of recruiting decisions are taken on your personality. Whether you are going neatly dressed, whether you are talking nicely, whether you are communicating very specifically to the point. So all these things needs to be taught to the student, whereas he'll be able to learn what he needs, he is going to face in the future after he passes engineering, after he passes MBA school. Success is not achieved by the size of brain, it's by the size of thoughts. The great success mantra, the theory of negation. Thank you very much. E-growth made me engage during difficult pandemic period, during last 1.5 years. We all were not busy, but e-growth definitely made me busy during last 1.5 years. Got excellent friends on the platform and off the platform also. Got excellent reach to unknown people. People one time, now they are friends. Got excellent knowledge supported by, got excellent knowledge also from eGrowth. Got very good excellent support from Ronika, guidance by Atul, Amit, Virendra, Hariharji. I tried best to perform. Don't know whether it was really. Thank you very much. थैंक्स अ लॉट।
प्रेजेंटेशन हटाओ, ये आपके और हमारे बीच में आ रही है।
हटा रहा हूँ, हटा रहा हूँ।
All right. So, आपने ये थैंक यू करके, ग्रेटिट्यूड करके, यू गिवन अ डिफरेंट टेंजेंट टू इट। All right. So, I invite all of us to please share a few words about how the journey has been over the past couple of quarters.
Yeah, Atul ji, I like to get the opportunity.
Yeah, please, sir.
Thank you, Atul ji, and Anand ji, a great presentation, which was of course expected. So at least for me, it took me back to college 45 years back actually. और मैं ये सोच रहा था, अगर यही लेक्चर हमें 45 साल पहले मिल गया होता तो पता नहीं कहाँ से कहाँ पहुंच गए होते एक्चुअली। दैट इज माय फ्रैंक फीडबैक। एंड नाउ आई विल स्टार्ट टीचिंग माय इंटर्न्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स, और आपको भी बुलाएंगे कभी यही चीजें रिपीट करने के लिए। तो ये इतना बढ़िया लगा, मतलब कि इतना अच्छा, और वो तो आपके सारी प्रेजेंटेशन पहले भी जो भी सुनी है, these have been great, but this was I think the real final shot, what we can like to say ultimate kind of thing. और दूसरा जो e-growth के बारे में, e-growth में मतलब you made it as if it is a farewell for you, which is not the case. First of all, you are not leaving. In any case, you are not leaving e-growth.
No, I'm not leaving e-growth. One minute, Satyaji. I'm not leaving e-growth. Don't worry about that.
Yeah.
What I'm saying is that somebody should share the responsibility now.
हाँ, वो देखेंगे, वो तो अलग बात है. But you are there, you will be there, we all will be there. Responsibility का तो अलग है. I think that topic we should take up on Friday. Friday meeting, if all of you agree. एंड कोई कोई तो मिलेगा, और कोई नहीं मिलेगा तो आप तो हैं, मतलब आप तो हैं ना, आप तो हैं।
आनंद जी, एक्सेलेंट प्रेजेंटेशन, इट वाज द नीड ऑफ द आवर, आई फील लॉट ऑफ लर्निंग्स फॉर मी आल्सो गोइंग थ्रू योर प्रेजेंटेशन, एक्सेलेंट, रियली एक्सेलेंट, इन फैक्ट आई वाज सीइंग दैट द स्कोप ऑफ दिस इज ह्यूज ह्यूज
Thank you.
Very
Thank
nice. You. Very well done. Very well created. The PPT was also excellent.
Thank you.
Rajesh sir.
Yeah. Hi, Anand ji.
Hi.
Good hearing you as always. And I think your the last quarter has been a very enriching quarter. Mm-hmm. And I would say largely it was your passion.
Yeah,
you know, which every person you brought on the platform, every session you did was very thought of, that, you know, what is the need of the day, pick up those kind of people, the kind of industrialists you got us connected with. I think I would say this was probably the best quarter since I got involved with the e-growth. So I would truly want to acknowledge you, Anandji. You've done really an excellent job.
And thank you very much.
You've set the ball rolling, and I hope the ball keeps rolling. Your presentation was excellent. I've been also off late been interacting, you know, with the campuses. And I find, yes, you are right that the involvement of the corporate with the campuses is not as high as what it should be. And even people who come out today, I'm, you know, kind of a corporate consultant with a company where I engage with them every Saturday. I find,
yeah, okay.
You know, we talked about things like vision, goals, etc. This is kind of alien to people. People don't even know what is a vision.
Correct.
You know, so it's very difficult to get them to understand that they need to have a vision, because they are today from, you know, one level to the other. They are just kind of, you know, doing assignments as are given to them. And I think, frankly, it's not very different what it was when I passed out, you know, 45 years ago. But I think it a lot has to depend on who becomes your coach in the organization.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Do you have a good coach in the organization? Do you have an organization which devotes a lot of time to building human beings? So if that is something which organizations, you know, start doing, things can become absolutely different. So, you know, things haven't changed. People coming out of colleges are as green behind the ears as we were.
Yeah.
So even I might have been from IIT, but what experience did I have? Zero. So when I got my first job, there was zero experience.
Yeah.
But over the period of years, the kind of learning I got in the first company which I joined, which is Thermax, I think it was probably the excellent foundation stone. So, which is what I am pursuing now, that the companies which I'm engaged with, that I built very strong foundations for the youngsters, and, you know, so that they can grow into mature and strong human beings. So thanks once again, Anandji. It was it's lovely knowing you, and we will continue to be in touch with each other.
Sure.
On and off e-growth, we will continue to stay in touch.
Sure.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Hi, Anandji, can you hear me?
Yeah.
How are you?
Good time. Good. After long time.
Late entry.
Yes. Yeah, sorry, I was in my car. I couldn't see the whole last 10-15 minutes. And first of all, thanks for doing this wonderful presentation. In fact, that reminded me of one talk I had given in a college on, I used to call that as employability skills, like you're talking about moving from campus to corporate. And this is a big gap area. And I'm not sure whether anybody is actually pursuing that to fill it. So just like we have the skills, we are lacking some skills. We're looking at capabilities. But once you enter corporate, we could talk about employability. Are they employable or not? So, and there are multiple things to be worked on that front. And first of all, by the way, one part I wanted to add to your presentation. One thing which happens, by the way, is when somebody joins the company first time, they will not lead a team. They will not be managing any team. They'll be working under a manager. Okay. So I was mentioning in one of the talk is they need to learn how to manage their managers first. Okay. How to manage the bosses. So it's a boss management. They need to learn that skill, because that's not taught anywhere else. So that's one of the skill which will help them in getting employable. So thank you for that. And plus, thanks for providing all the support and leadership in the e-growth and inner circle throughout, and we work together. So I really enjoyed that, a lot of discussions and sessions and meetings. So I think your passion shows. And when you had joined inner circle, I was not expecting this to be there. Okay. So I was pleasantly surprised and to see you perform so well. Thank you so much.
Yeah, Atul ji, जो अमित जी ने बोला, मैं उस पे बस एक लाइन ऐड करना चाहता हूँ. जो बॉस मैनेजमेंट इन्होंने कहा, वो एक्चुअली हमारे रेलवे कैरियर में, वेर आई वर्क फॉर अबाउट 15 इयर्स, एक ही चीज बस बोला जाता है, सीखा जाता है और किया जाता है, एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड बॉस मैनेजमेंट. जो साहब ने बोला, हम 15 साल सरकार में जो किया काम, कुछ भी नहीं किया एक्चुअली, अदर देन मैनेजिंग अवर बॉस. तो कॉर्पोरेट से ज्यादा ये सरकार में ज्यादा जरूरी है अमित जी, बॉस मैनेजमेंट. कॉर्पोरेट में तो बॉस, इफ बॉस इज मैनेजर देन ओनली यू हैव टू मैनेज हिम, बट नॉर्मली बॉस इज ए मेंटर, नॉर्मली बॉस इज ए स्पॉन्सर, मतलब बॉस मैनेजर नहीं होता है नॉर्मल कॉर्पोरेट में, बट रियल बॉस गवर्नमेंट में होता है, और इसीलिए हमें गवर्नमेंट में बॉस मैनेजमेंट सिखाया भी जाता है और हम प्रैक्टिस भी वही करते हैं और सिर्फ वही करते हैं सरकार में और कुछ भी नहीं करते। थैंक यू।
तो सत्या जी अभी कोई ना कोई बोलेंगे कि जी घर में भी बॉस मैनेजमेंट होता है।
वो नेचुरल है और बॉस मैनेजेज यू और यू मैनेज द बॉस, वो उसमें कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता, आप एक ऑप्शन नहीं है, किसी पे भी ऑप्शन नहीं है,
और वो नेचुरल बिल्कुल। और वो सरकार और कॉर्पोरेट वाला बॉस के ऊपर तो फिर कुछ लोगों ने लिखा होगा, घर वाले बॉस के ऊपर कोई लिख भी नहीं सकता।
नहीं, मेरे हिसाब से गूगल पे मिल जाएगा, वैसे गूगल से मैंने पूछा था एक बार, तो उसमें पूछा भाई पुट ए क्वेश्चन, आई पुट ए क्वेश्चन हाउ टू मैनेज योर वाइफ।
अभी 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 क्या हो गया वीरेंद्र जी ना, अभी फोन से निकल कर आएंगे। वीरेंद्र जी ने हाथ खड़ा किया था और बीच में अमित चावला जी बीच में आ गए थे, अब वीरेंद्र जी ने एकदम फोन के बीच से निकल कर आ रहे हैं कि भाई मेरा नंबर कब आएगा।
सो वीरेंद्र, दैट इज कॉल्ड टाइम मैनेजमेंट।
या
first of all it was wonderful session Anandji as usual, and there are two things which you always do, that is one is Anandji Anand or dusra is value addition. So what I have seen is whenever you come on any sessions, you bring a lot of energy, positivity and Anand into the system. Definitely e-growth, and we all are a place to be associated with you and experiencing or connecting with you. So session was wonderful. जैसे कि मुझे भी मेरे सीडेट के दिन याद है, जब मैं अपनी कंपनी पहली 2016 में स्टार्ट किया था, तो आई यूज्ड टू मीट ऑल दी कॉलेजेस। महाराष्ट्र के अंदर ऐसा कोई कॉलेज नहीं बचा होगा शायद, मैं कह नहीं, और तब यही काम करते थे कि प्रेजेंटेशन दे रहे थे सभी को। तो डेफिनेटली वो ओल्ड डेज बहुत ज्यादा कॉल कर गए, बट डेफिनेटली शायद हम आपके समान इफेक्टिव नहीं रहे जितने आपने बहुत अच्छे से इफेक्टिवली उसको अभी प्रेजेंट किया है। एंड सेकेंडली अभी जो आपने ग्रोथ के बारे में और अपने लास्ट सेशन के बारे में लिखा था, सो मेरा ये कहना है कि दैट्स टोटली अ डिफरेंट कॉल, नॉट टुडे, बट मे बी आप उसको बाद में डिस्कस करें, बट डेफिनेटली हैविंग अ प्रेसिडेंट और मे बी जो भी टेन्योर आपके समान रहा है, समय रहा है, दैट वाज वंडरफुल, दैट्स व्हाट द वन वर्ड व्हिच आई वांट टू से, इट वाज अ ग्रेट जर्नी एंड वी आर ब्लेस्ड टू हैव यू आरएनसी विद अस, लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू अ लॉन्ग लॉन्ग जर्नी।
All right. Thank you, Virendra ji. Rikesh ji.
हाँ, thank you very much. एक तो मैं तो सॉरी कहता हूँ सभी लोगों को, क्योंकि मैं बहुत लेट आया आनंद जी, मैंने आपको बहुत कुछ मिस किया ऐसा मुझे लग रहा है।
सलमान खान ने कहा था नो थैंक यू नो सॉरी।
चलो अच्छी बात है। तो बात यहाँ पे ये मैं देख रहा हूँ कि जो कैंपस के बारे में समझो कहा जाता है, तो इमर्जिंग लीडर्स, इमर्जिंग एंटरप्रेनर्स और इमर्जिंग द पर्टिकुलर पाथ फाइंडर, तो ऐसे तीन तरीके के जो लोग, और एक होता है एक सर्विस क्लास पीपल, ऐसे चार डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज के लोग जब निर्माण होते हैं, तो सबसे पहले तो इस कैंपस में तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि एजुकेशन जो है, एजुकेटिंग, वॉट इज द एजुकेशन और एजुकेटिंग, ट्रेनिंग, coaching and mentoring, these are the four different aspects has to be very very clarified, and whatever the professors are there or whatever the guest speakers also there, whatever the different programs they are conducting there, they should have the important of that particular, all these four important aspects. Second thing, whatever the things might be, definitely share the energy nicely, but here I would like to contribute a very important thing. Either whenever we start working anywhere, and we are finding there are too many bosses, but very, very less the subordinates. At that point, at that campus area, the how to become a subordinate, because see the things, subordination and create that power of the subordinate means how to become a subordinate. That is the most important to grow. If you will not become a best subordinate of your boss or your superior or your senior, then everything is will be failed. Because see the thing, it is such a unique journey when you are the subordinate with your the boss, that is really pathfinding for yourself. When that student understands, I have to be subordinate earlier, beginning, and that subordinate, power of the subordinate, how he will subordinate, then definitely that power will shift him in a, such a wonderful level. And that has to be nurtured at the time of that rural campus. And that is very, very important. Second thing, just I would like to ask here, so what is the e-growth? I love the e-growth. Really, frankly, I'm telling you, I'm learning so many things, like great people, their great experiences, and it is a knowledge enhancing process. And that is really helping me in my family managed business also. Whomsoever are the family people and family members are there, I always share them how to become a subordinate. And that subordination, develop that particular culture inside, that is a really wonderful. And then there is no time one can progress better and he become a boss. And that possibility is lying in the art of subordinate. So thank you very much, Atul. You have given us the wonderful dais where we can share our the thoughts and views, as well as you are sharing the wonderful, the speaker and their knowledge. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Anybody else would like to share? Anandji. Yeah, please, Sujata ji.
Yeah. So this was Anand, sir, this was a wonderful session, actually. I mean, I personally learned a lot. I mean, when I was a professor at MBA college, the scenario has changed in 15 to 17 years. But today, when I'm working, when I'm an employment provider, I really got a new insights of how, what, and what are the things I need to take care, and what the what are the expectations also from as an employer, and how to manage as the employer. So thank you so much. It was eye opener. Thank you.
Thank you, Sujata ji. Anand ji.
Tell me.
Yeah. So thank you. Diwali mein wo ek phulzhadi ko aag lagate hain, uske baad mein sab kuch rang hi rang ho jata hai. That's what you've done, right? So thank you. I'd just like to add one piece here. All of us right now are on the other side. We are on the corporate side. And we are also on the side that we are not in the campus anymore. I think as human beings, it is our responsibility. Ye hamara uttardayitva hai. Ki hum next generation, ya next, I won't say generation, but at least jo next level jo aa raha hai, usko we give enough space. We create that environment where it can prosper. And that is our responsibility. Very often when a student goes as an intern to an organization, he or she is treated as a labor, which is available at a lower cost. Whereas if we start relating to that boy or a girl as my own son or a daughter, how I would like my daughter or my son to be treated, if I treat that intern in that fashion, I promise you we will be creating a whole generation of excellent workmen.
True.
Work people.
Very true.
If we take this back home, I think that's awesome. Right? Sometime in class 8, I heard a doha, which I still carry with me. Guru kumhar shish kumbh hai, घड़ी घड़ी काड़े खोट अंतर हाथ हार दे बाहर मारे चोट
चोट
सो एज somebody who's giving an opportunity to somebody else to work it is our job to work or to be a guru guru ka kaam hai andar support dena and bahar se usko chot marna so that वो घड़ा जब पकेगा कल को जब वो कॉर्पोरेट बनेगा ही शुड बी एबल टू टेल समबडी दिस इज द पर्सन हु ऑल्टर्ड माय लाइफ फॉर गुड इफ दिस इज व्हाट वी आर डूइंग एन ऑसम जॉब इवन टुडे आई एम श्योर ऑल ऑफ अस वुड हैव कम अक्रॉस व्हाट्सएप मैसेजेस फ्रॉम सुधा मूर्ति वेयर शी इज टॉकिंग अबाउट रतन टाटा This is who a boss is. If we aspire to be a boss of that kind, that another super boss is writing about him or her, that this is what shaped my life. I think we're creating a corporate environment which is uber cool. This is what I picked up from this conversation. Thanks, Anandji. Having said this, Anandji, I would like to take away a couple of minutes from you. And I invite all of you to share some words for Ronika because Ronika, aaj Eid ka chand hai, wo bhi nikla hua hai. Ronika generally does not give her appearance on such events. So if you'd like to share something for her, I think she deserves something.
Yeah, actually.
Please.
Ronika ji, it will be very glad if you can show your face to us first.
Aaj Eid ka chand dikha dijiye.
Hello.
Aji.
Yeah, yeah. She's coming on the platform. Don't worry. Yeah. Good evening.
Hello.
Ronika ji, it was really a wonderful journey.
Ye wala kaise matlab ki, of course, she deserves praise, all that, but she is there and she will be there. So, but anyway, as you have told, I will like to express my appreciation as well as.
I think after Atul, I think I am the person who troubled her most.
That's up to her to decide.
I know.
नहीं नहीं तो इतना बड़ा इतनी बड़ी नहीं हूँ मैं.
जिसको बोला जाता है back end. तो back end really
wonderful
backbone.
Backbone.
Ronika, you are looking really great today. Actually, you are a new Ronika actually, and I must compliment your appearance. In addition to whatever you have done, and hope you will keep doing. All
what
the best,
Ronika. I've already mentioned in the group also that she's very humble. That is first part, and which is the most required qualities in today's scenario. That is one part. Second part, she really cooperated or she really supported from the back end for anything whenever it was necessary. She made it. And absolutely, I don't know what went wrong with her, why she is not going to be there in future.
No, she there's nothing gone wrong with her. There's something gone wrong with me.
Acha. What went wrong with you, what then?
I'm not able to afford to pay her.
Okay.
Still I'm here, sir.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay, anyhow, it was please. Really a wonderful journey with Ronika also. She supported now almost for about 9 months or so. I used to get something done from her and she has supported me very correctly in time and sometimes even on the holidays. So Ronika ji, anyway, whether you are there or not, that's a different story, but we'll be in touch with each other and let us see how best we'll be able to continue. All the best to you.
Thank you. Rajesh ji.
Yeah, hi Ronika. I can't see your face.
I think you're on the phone, that's why. Yeah.
Okay. Let me. Yeah. Hi, Ronika. You know, the way you did is what reminded me when I started my job.
You got mute. Rajesh, you went mute, yeah.
So, you know, there were one section of people who would do less but blow their trumpet more. And there were the others who would do their work and the work would be seen. So, you are from the second category. So, you do your work and that's why things move. So, don't lose this trait of yours. This is a very, very powerful trait. You are that silent backbone of wherever you go, you will be like a backbone. So continue practicing what you have done here. And yes, and wish you very, very best for your future.
Thank you so much, Rajeshji.
Ronika, when we are going to have our 1-to-1 again?
For future, I wish you all the best. I have already mentioned on a group that if you are looking for some change or if you are looking for a job, please share your resume so that at least let me see what best I can do there.
Okay, I will send it to you.
Virendra has an office in Delhi nowadays, so you don't worry.
He's also planning an office in Dubai.
Achha.
Yes, very soon.
Aray, bhai, Ronika, I am ready to go to Dubai in your office. Don't worry.
Ronika, one question. Where do you stay in Delhi?
North Delhi, near Delhi University Metro Station.
Where is that? North Delhi means?
North Delhi mein padta hai. GTB, Delhi University, aapne suna hoga. ISBT.
Okay.
ISBT next. To next.
All right. Yeah. Just like Viren said, send me your CV too. Because one of the companies where I'm a corporate consultant.
Okay.
Or they can have somebody like you.
ठीक है, हाँ, मुझे भी बात करनी है रोनिका से, रोनिका के बारे में भी. रोनिका, she's such a sweet lady. I mean, हिंदी में मृदुभाषी बोलते हैं. She's the lady who doesn't get irritated with a repetitive work. I have found with her. Every time we ask her to do something, she has a quick reply and quick response. And that too in, you know, like in a positive way. So, मैंने काफी कम उन रोनिका के साथ interact किया है, but she's a lovely lady. Ronika, I'll definitely have a talk with you and we will carry forward our pending project.
Sure. I am keen into that. That's why. Thank you.
Yeah.
Hello. Hello.
Hello, sir. Hello.
मुझे भी रोनिका के बारे में तो कुछ तो कहना तो होगा ही.
Not necessary.
राजी ने.
Yeah, not necessary, sir.
राजा ने जो मुझे बताना था वो तो उसने बोली दिया कि backbone. मैं और एक additional word शब्द डालूंगा यहाँ पे. Backbone, bone of the ego. So this is really wonderful. Ronika aur jaise Sudha ji ne kaha, jab bhi koi aavashyakta ho to instantly uska message hame mil jata hai aur feedback mil jata hai. That is a really great support structure. Aur subordinate, I would like to say, I would like to, today's word I would like to offer you and share for you. You are the subordinate, wonderful subordinate. And you will definitely path maker for yourself.
Second thing,
I already accepted your CV. I already deliver your CV in a Savita Chemicals. Those are the oil industries, and they will look forward for that. And you also connect to them if you want to come. Because ultimately, you should grow. You should be happy, healthy, and safe, and hold your family. That is your best wishes from us.
And
thank
you.
So thank you, Renika. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Anybody else?
I just wanted to add one story.
Yeah, please.
Which happened actually, took place with Ronik only. It is the old story of Mr. Krishnamurti. Ronika, I hope you remember everything. The story of Krishnamurti actually.
See,
Krishnamurti, I should not say it. I hope there is no recording now.
I can stop the recording if you say.
But it is better if you can stop it.